Hi students, welcome to a program where I am going to do a frequency count of the elements of an array. Let us say I have an input into an array called as A, where I read numbers 1, 2, 3, 1, 2 and 4. First, what I am going to do here is I am going to take each number and insert it into array B. The first time I am inserting it, this particular number 1 frequency I am going to make it as 1. Then when I take a look at 2, 2 is not there, so I'm going to insert 2. I'm going to make the frequency also 1. Then next time I find 3, I'm going to insert it into array B, again with the initial frequency of 1. Then I look for 1, and when I try to insert it, I already see that 1 is in the array B. So all that I do is I increase the frequency of 1 by 1, so 1 becomes 2. Then I look at 2. When I search in array B, 2 is already there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to increase the frequency of 2 by 1. Then I look for 4. 4, when I search, is not in array B. So I'm going to insert in array B and put an initial frequency of 1. So my output is simply going to print number 1 has a frequency of 2, number 2 has a frequency of 2, number 3 has a frequency of 1, and number 4 has a frequency of 1. So in order to solve this particular problem, I require 3 arrays. The first array is used to read the input from the user, let me call it array A, with maximum elements of 50. Array B is going to store all the unique elements from array A into array B. And an array called as frequency is going to keep track of the frequency of all these numbers entered in array A. So first thing what I am doing here is, I have defined an array A size max. Max in mine is 50. Array B, which is going to store the or hold the unique numbers, is also size 50 because all the numbers entered could be unique. Then N is going to tell me what are the number of elements entered into an array. So let's say I say user has entered 10 numbers into an array. Then I am going to pass on this name of the array and 10 into this read array. Now I am going to ask the user enter 10 elements into the array. So what user is going to do here is, he is going to start entering numbers, any set of numbers he likes, but limited to 10 numbers. Then I am calling a function called as findUnique. This is the main function which is used to create the frequency of each unique number. So for this findUnique, I am sending the name of the array, I am sending array B, and I am sending the number of numbers entered by the user. So let's see how this main frequency list works. This you will see is very, very similar to your previous program where I am trying to print the unique numbers in an array. The only new thing I have done is I have taken an array called as frequency, which keeps track of the frequency of each element, and its size is also equal to max. Then starting from the 0th location of array A till I have processed all the numbers of array A, I do this search. So let us say my first number is 1. I am sending that number from array A. Array Y represents array B. Array X represents array A. Okay. And frequency represents this frequency array, which keeps track of the frequency. And counter is a variable used to find the new position where I should insert a new unique number into array B. So what I am doing is, whenever I get a number in array A, I send it here. Here what I do is, I try to see if that number already exists in the unique array Y or array B. If the number already exists, then all that I do is, I increase the frequency by 1 and then I go back. Now let us say I send a number which does not exist. So when I come out of this for loop, let's say the counter is 0. So at the 0th position of array B or array Y, I am going to insert the number. Then I am going to see that the initial frequency is 1. Then I am increasing the value of counter by 1 so that when next time when a new number comes, I can insert it at the next vacant position. So this particular method, I'll keep doing it till I am done inserting all the unique numbers into the array as well as calculating their frequency. Once the frequency is done, then I am going to print this unique. In print unique, I am going to print the unique number, each unique number along with its frequency. So let's try to take this piece of code. Let's try to run it, and I'll try to do a better explanation or a more detailed explanation once we run this particular piece of code. So let's see if it compiles first. This is our first statement now. The number of elements into the array. Let's say I'm going to enter 10 numbers into the array. So here, the next thing is I'm going to be calling read array. So now in read array, I'm going to pass on those 10 numbers. So let the numbers be 0, 1, 2, 3. Then let me say 3, 2, 0. Then 7, 6. I hope I have entered 10 numbers. One more, I guess. So let's say 7 again. So here if you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have entered 10 numbers. Then once I enter 10 numbers, then I call the function called as find unique along with this input array A, the unique array B, and the total number of elements entered. So I'm going to now come here. So once I come here, let's see what we try to do. So here if you see, 0 has occurred 2 times, 1 has occurred only once, 2 has occurred 2 times, 3 has occurred 2 times, 7 has occurred 2 times, and 6 has occurred 1 time. So it's printed frequency of the element. So what happened? Let me explain. When I took 0, the first time 0 was sent to the search, it got inserted into array Y, which actually represents array B. Because I is equal to 0, 0 less than 0 is false. So the first number 0 got at the 0th position, 0 got stored. Then the frequency of 0 became 1. Then I created the next position so that when I get a new number, I can store it at the next position. Next time when 1 came, I is 0, 0 less than 1 is true. Okay. So is 1 equal to 0? No. So I became 1. 1 is less than 1 is false. Then counter is 1. In the first position I install or insert 1. I make the frequency 1. Then I insert the number. I make frequency 1 in the next step. Then I increase it so that I'm able to go to the next position in array B or array Y. Then next time again when I see 2, the 2 is passed on here. 2 does not exist, so it's going to insert 2 in the next position. Alright, then finally when 3 comes first time, it's again inserted. When 3 occurs again, then its frequency count is increased by 1 in this particular place here. So I would suggest, please take a look at the input, take a look at the output, single step through the code, and you'll really understand how this particular program works. Because to find the frequency of a list of numbers in an array, there may be multiple ways. I have shown you one particular way of trying to find the frequency.